Ano daw po ba talaga ang purpose ng buhay? Kung bakit ginawa ng Diyos?
Ay, meron. Napakagandang tanong niya. What is the meaning of life? What is the purpose of life? Napakaganda po niyan. Kung ang itinatanong mo, if your question refers to life on earth, because there are two lives in the Bible. I have to clarify this first. We have two lives. The first is the temporary life we have on earth, and the next is the everlasting life that is after the resurrection. Ngayon, ano ba ang purpose of life? The best answer is recorded in the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 12 verse 13. It says,
"Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep His commandments, for this is the whole duty of man."
Have you noticed that? Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. This is the conclusion of everything that exists. Everything we do, everything we enjoy in life, everything that we have, every resources that God have given us, the conclusion is this, that we have to fear God and obey His commandments, for it is the whole duty of man. Ito ang wakas ng bagay. Lahat ay narinig. Ikaw ay matakot sa Diyos, sundin mo ang kanyang mga utos, sapagkat ito ang buong katungkulan ng tao. Sa Kastila, ang sabi ron, "El fin de todo el sermon es oído. Teme a Dios y guarda sus mandamientos, porque esto es toda la felicidad del hombre." Wala nang ibang dahilan ng buhay, kundi tayo kumilala sa Diyos. After all, He is our Maker, He is our God, He is our Provider, and He is our Judge. Yun ang gagawin natin. That's the most important thing in life, to acknowledge the existence of that great Creator who have created us, and to do His will so that we will enjoy life eternal after the resurrection. There is another life. Tandaan nyo, wala nang ibang dahilan ng buhay kundi para kumilala tayo sa Diyos. Sumunod tayo sa kanyang utos para makasama natin siya sa langit. Wala na pong ibang dahilan ng buhay. Wala namang kwenta ang buhay kung ikaw eh mayaman ka. Eh maiiwan mo naman eh. Ha? 40 milyong hektarya ng lupa ang pag-aari mo. Ang titulo mo ganyan kakapal ang dami. Pag namatay ka, anin mo 'yon. 1 metro kwadrado ka lang. What are you going to do with acres and upon acres and hectares upon hectares of land that you have accumulated, the vast wealth that you have acquired for yourself, whether in the rightful manner or in the wrong manner of acquiring wealth? What will that do to you? Sometimes it will even prejudice your salvation, your knowledge, your belief in God. When a people or when a person is very rich, he feels that he has everything in this world. He doesn't need anymore the services of people. And sometimes he feels that he does not need anymore God because he is very much stable compared to the poor who always pray to God just for a breakfast. At night, God, our problem is the breakfast that we have. We must have tomorrow. The breakfast for my sons and daughters. He kneels and prays to God because he has nothing in life. He just, the only hope in him is that he believes in God. Minus God, then everything will be in vain. Alisin mo ang Diyos, wala na pong kwenta ang buhay. Wala nang sagot ang ibang tanong. Pag wala ang Diyos, minus God, then everything will fall down. But with God, every question will be answered. Every problem will be solved. Come judgment.